Open in the year 2000. We're live inside Minute Maid Park here in downtown Houston. Here it's the little guys on the big stage between the Scranton Wilkes-Barre Rail Riders and the Sugar Land Skeeters.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome your Sugar Land Skeeters.
And now here is Tim LoCastro. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Ball. 2-2.
High in the air and deep to left center field. The throw is wild and it gets away. Tag comes down and they're gonna get him at third. Aggressive base running there following some shoddy defensive play, but it doesn't work out for him. So now to the plate, Andrew Velasquez. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Now another 2-2.
Ball.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Drilled right back up the middle, and that'll get on through into center, and he's got himself a one-out hit.
That is third. The first base
standing in now, Chris Gittens. A ball and two strikes.
1-2, the count.
Now this is hit not all that hard out to second. Scooped up, and indeed he won't try to force it at second. He'll just flip on to first for the sure out. So a runner in scoring that's position good. With two men gone. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Clint Frazier. The set and the 1-1.
These are the moments right here. You got a good pitcher on the mound. You don't know if these opportunities are going to present themselves throughout the course of the game. You have to capitalize in this situation.
Adolph
gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. Played is Ross Adolph. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1 home. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Digging in will be Marwin Gonzalez as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box. A 3-2 pitch. Now a swing as he stays alive as this is fouled back right off the catcher's arm. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. Next to dig in, Ronnie Dawson. Bases are empty here with two men out. And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. The 1-2. Starting to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone. No one on with one down, and it brings Esteban Florial in at the plate. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now.
That's a tough pitch for a batter. If you're not expecting it, you'll end up with half a bat after you swing.
And he gets around on one and hits it high and deep to straightaway right. A leap, but he can't bring it back into the park. It's a home run. At the plate now, Miguel Andujar. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2. Count remains full. The next 3-2. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
The third baseman.
Next to hit is Mandy Alvarez. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And that fastball is too much for him there. 1-2. Line to the right side. And that's in there. Base hit. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now. Into the box now, Rob Brantley. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. So here is Tim LoCastro. And recall he doubled his first time through, but was thrown out trying to stretch that into a triple.
Yeah, and he certainly got the wheels trying to stretch a double into a triple. But it's sort of a killer to the club when you can't leg it out.
2-2, here it is.
Wow, these guys are really grinding out their at-bats in this one. They're not making any outs easy to get. And that, of course, is having a huge...
We'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. Leading off the inning, it'll be Taylor Jones. And they could use a spark from him here. And it's fouled away. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
The third baseman.
Now to bat, number 13. And we'll see if he can at least put the ball in play, something the first four men have been unable to do. And this is strike three call. Make it five straight punch-outs. Two away now.
The left fielder. Jordan.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Popped him up. Brantley has a play, and the inning is over. Digging in, the switch hitter, Andrew Velasquez. He'll be the one to greet Justin Verlander to start the inning. Here now the 2-2. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. Stubbs recovers, and he makes the throw to first. Velasquez retired, and there's one away.
The first baseman.
And now in the box, Chris Gittens. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Fastball was too much for him there. Swung right through it.
The MO of this pitcher in the early going is certainly establishing the inside part of the plate. He has been dominant. Sometimes you just got to tip your hat if a guy can effectively, consistently pitch inside like he is.
Now batter.
Two down, no one on base. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Clint Frazier. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. A payoff pitch one more time. And he got another one here. He strikes out the side. He set down five in a row via the punch out, and the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Freudis Nova. And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
Batting it.
Next up is Robel Garcia.
Garcia.
And this is taken for a called strike, and he's not in love with that call either. It's 1-2 now. Line drive snagged on a short hop, and there's out number two. Now to the plate here is Garrett Stubbs. Two out, nobody on. And he lays off the pitch down and away. Ball two. Fly ball right down the line and left. Frazier is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Stepping up is Aaron Hicks. He went down on strikes in his last at bat. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1.
Yeah. Full count.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Popped up. Number 13 over to his left. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Next to stand in is Esteban Florial. Off to a fine start in this one after launching a homer his first time up.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
Fouled off. The 3-2 pitch. Hard on the ground towards short. Throw on the first, and Verlander's got it going here. Two away. Base is empty, two away. And striding into the plate, it'll be Miguel Andujar. Bases are empty here with two men out. Pitch popped up. Gonzalez is there for it. And he makes the play to end the inning. Leading off the inning, it'll be Ross Adolph as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up.
Still a big bagel in that hit column. And this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
Fastball catches the black there for a called strike.
Well executed fastball right at the knees. Going to be a long day for this offense if he stays in that spot.
This one smoked the other way, high and deep to left. And he's going to have room to put this one away, and that's the first out. One out, base is empty, and into back next, the utility man extraordinaire Marwin Gonzalez. Now the pitch. High in the air out to center field. And Hicks will settle under this one for the second out. Digging in next, Ronnie Dawson looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
Two balls, one strike.
Now a fastball runs inside and drills him. Oh, that's gotta hurt. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Taylor Jones, struck out in his first at bat. Had him off stride that time, and it's one and two.
Woo, that was an ugly swing. If I'm pitching right now, I'm throwing that same pitch again. That was ugly.
To two balls and two strikes now.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Grounded weakly down the line toward third. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Dawson, the runner at first with two gone. Slow roller down the third baseline. throw in time, and the side is retired. New inning set to get underway, and set to go is the third baseman, Mandy Alvarez. Now the 1-1 pitch. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Brewer is right there as he puts it away, no problem for the first down. Now in the box, Rob Brantley. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 1-1 is a fastball that misses.
That's the ball.
Hey, I hope that call doesn't throw him off his game right here. He's been pitching one heck of a game, and I'd hate to see the umpire getting his head right now.
All even now, 2-2. High and deep to straightaway right. Right fielder looking up, still going back. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. At the plate, Tim LoCastro. High in the air into shallow left center. Brewer comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number two. Stepping in next, Andrew Velasquez. 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. The 1-1 home. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike
two.
Not much you can do with that one. Tied him up in knots.
Hit on the ground toward the left. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Now at the plate, number 13 comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
The count now at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Now batting.
Ready now is Jordan Brewer. 0-for-1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through.
One ball, two strikes.
Hey, I can understand this batter's frustration right here. He's trying to be aggressive and get something going for his team. They're getting shut out in the fifth inning, but that's exactly why they're getting shut out. You need to keyhole and stay on the attack and make this pitcher come in the middle of the plate.
No batter. Number one.
Into the box, Freudis Nova. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Swinging a blooper to the right side. LoCastro backs up and takes care of it. 2 away. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Romo Garcia. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Now a throw over. The 1-1.
Yeah.
Brewer leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Swung right over the top of that one as this is a little dribbler out in front of the mound. So they do get their first hit, but their first run will have to wait as the inning is over. Set for the start of the inning, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Chris Gittens. Line hard deep into left. Brewer is there, and he'll bring this one in. Now it'll be Clint Frazier, struck out in his last trip to the plate. One out, nobody on. Down low,
two balls and a strike. 2 balls, 1 strike.
And he misses again, ball 3. The the 3-1 pitch. Hit hard up the middle. And that's the second out. So now here is Aaron Hicks. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. Fouled away.
Obviously, he's not fatiguing whatsoever. Still in the mid to high 90s with his fastball. These guys got to stay on.
Bullet to second base. A fine play, and that ends the inning. At the plate now is Garrett Stubbs. He'll get things started here in the second half of the sixth. The 1-1. A shot to second base and handled for the first out.
Now batting.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Ross Adolph. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-for-2 at this point. Hit on the ground out to short. And very quickly there, they're two gone to start the inning.
Now
to the plate, Marwin Gonzalez. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. One and two now as that one's fouled off.
Hey, with two outs in the number two hole, you're just trying to get on. You got the big boys coming up behind you.
And he fouls this one off. He'll try again, 1-2. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Pedro Baez is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
For the Skeeters, number 52.
And that'll bring in Esteban Florial. Comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. And it's fouled away. The 1-2.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away, so now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
The 2-2 swung on and missed strike three. And that'll bring up Miguel Andujar. He got under one and popped out his last time up.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over.
So he gets the swinging strikeout on the changeup. Miguel Andujar is the second out in the seventh inning. The 1-1.
Hey, last two pitches back to back, off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those four pitches. Statistics class tells me I'm sitting fast.
3-2, full count. Now the payoff pitch home is swung on and missed. He got him. So now into the box is Ronnie Dawson. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch. The 1-1 home. Oh, and he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ballgame.
Now batting, first baseman.
Next up, Taylor Jones. He's hitless in the game, as is much of the rest of his team. All even at 2-2.
I mean, this offense has struggled because they haven't been able to make the adjustment. He stayed staunch on the outer half, and these guys have not worked the ball the other way.
Full count, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Popped him up. Velasquez is under it. He's got it, and there are two down now. Next, it'll be number 13. 0-for-2 with a couple of strikeouts for him so far. The 1-1 home. There's a low changeup that's laid off.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Count even at 2-2. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. This pitch is popped up. Gittens waits on it. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. So stepping in is Rob Brantley. He'll start us off in the eighth. A 1-1. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Slap hard the opposite way, and there's a base hit, so a chance to add a little insurance here as the leadoff man is on to start the eighth.
Now back the second baseman, Tim LoCastro.
To the plate now, Tim LoCastro. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. He's running.
Two balls, two strikes.
It's high, but a fine play to come down with it at second, and he's out trying to steal a base. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. And now, Andrew Velasquez. He bounced out last time up. Rolled slowly down the third baseline. And he'll reach first safely.
Now batting, the first baseman.
Now a throw over to first. And he is tagged out here. Boy, a bad mistake that time as he's picked off to end the inning. Into the box, Jordan Brewer. A hit in two tries so far. Towards second. And he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. Next, here is Priudis Nova. Bases are empty, one man out. High in the air down the right field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. He makes the throw to first. Two down. Next will be the designated hitter. Rubel Garcia grounded out in his last at bat. Pulled toward right center field. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Brandon Belak enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Stepping in once again is Chris Gittens, and he's 0-for in this one, batting out of the three spot. Swing and a ball pulled hard down the line and left, and that's a fair ball heading for the scoreboard near the Crawford boxes. He'll get it into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit. So now to the plate, Clint Frazier.
And
that misses 2-1.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Set. Here's the 3-1. Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike. Swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out. Next, it'll be Aaron Hicks. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
The 1-2 misses, ball two. Hit out towards second. And there are two away now. Big spot here, and it'll be Esteban Florio. Though they might pitch around him here with a couple of bases empty. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. A ball and two strikes now. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The next 1-2 pitch. Grounded back up the middle. He's got it. Throwing the dirt, but a good scoop at first. Saves an error as the side is retired. Aaron O'Day is the man called on to close this one and earn a save in the ninth.
Number 56.
Bottom of the inning now, and next will be the speedy catcher, Garrett Stubbs. Ready with the 1-1. And he misses, 2-1. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2.
Hey, it's tough when your team is being held scoreless on the scoreboard. He was trying to put him on the board with a swing like that one.
Grounded down the third baseline. Well, this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. This one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
Yeah, well, down two, you better believe they gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tied run to the plate.
Half swing here, but it won't matter. It's strike three called anyway, and that's out number one.
The right fielder. Angel.
The 2-1. Strike two, swinging.
Two and two's the count.
Someone on this offense needs to take it upon themselves to have a quality AB and start the line moving again.
Still 2-2. Here's the pitch. And he strikes him out as well. So two punch outs to begin the outing out of the pen.
The batter.
Here's Marwin Gonzalez now. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Fouled off. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes.
Nope, ball.
Great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
One strike from a shutout. Here it comes. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. And this is a strike three called. And a bit of a questionable ending there as the ball game is over.
Man, we were treated to a nice pitcher's duel in this one. Both starters throwing strikes. They worked deep. And both were in command of the game. It really came down to a few key at-bats. This was a fun game to watch.
This evening's game finishes 2-0 the final score. The Scranton-Wilkes-Barre Rail Riders took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Davey Garcia earns the victory on the mound. Justin Verlander pitched well, allowing only two earned, but ends up taking the loss. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRozan, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click over to theshow.com.
For the Rail Riders, two runs on eight hits, no errors. They left four men on base. For the Skeeters, no runs, just one hit, no errors. They left two men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 31 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.